Don't know what happened.
We know that some of you joined us previously.
If you're back with us, thanks for sticking around.
Because it's going to be worth it.
It's totally going to be worth it because Coastal Seafood's in the house. So we're making fish, Minnesota fish.
Freshwater native fish inspired dishes.
That's right, because of the fishing opener this weekend, a lot of people will be fishing and catching some stuff. It's a walleye opener specifically.
And people can buy this book, right?
They absolutely can. It is available through the University of Minnesota. The Minnesota Historical Society Press website, or you can get it Barnes & Noble, yep. Amazon, basically
modern
anywhere books are available.
Modern cooking freshwater fish. So normally when we have you guys on, we're cooking crab or lobster or oysters or all things that everybody likes, but this is
today
Minnesota
we're keeping
specific.
It local.
Because
it local.
At midnight, tomorrow night, the walleye
the
fishing
opener. The anglers are going to be out with their rods and ready to go.
It's time of the season people have been waiting for, so we want to give them some things to do.
And even and mom can get into this for brunch.
Yeah, I mean,
these are absolutely.
Really good cook this up for mama on Sunday. So what kind of fish are we cooking with today?
So today we've got sort of a variety of things. We're going to do
very colorful.
It is.
Want to think of Minnesota fish in
springtime and so we're doing today a variety of things. We've got lake trout.
Ooh.
We've got walleye, as you mentioned, perch and northern pike, which is
I've
something
I've never had
that,
northern pike.
Yeah, northern is something
we never
that,
caught any, so I never had any. We ate a lot of sunfish.
Sunfish, yeah.
Northern is one of those fish that a lot of people kind of regulate sport fishing because of the bones and the structure of the fish.
You were saying
fish
when
and,
we were on before,
yeah.
That, you thought it was an underrated fish.
I think it's very underrated. It's actually a very steaky fish.
Oh, it's meaty?
So it's probably something
like
it's
a little bit closer. Like the swordfish of the lakes.
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
Look
it's
at
probably
you with your
more
knowledge.
Close to that than a lot of the other lake fish species.
Interesting.
So it's really good for grilling because it is hardier.
Yeah.
Like that.
You don't think
nice
of perch hand. Being eaten very often.
No, you know.
Remember my grandpa sadly. Always said perch is horrible. They're bottom feeders or something weird. I don't know.
There's so many weird myths about Minnesota fish.
It's, jazz it up. That's the point. Crazy. You take a fish, you jazz it up with some spices and some good flavors.
Absolutely. And basically all of these kind of started the same way with the exception of this guy here, where they were all grilled fish. So
cool.
The lake trout on this flatbread grilled it first and then just kind of flaked it and topped this with it. The perch was grilled and then same kind of deal where it was sort of shredded and split up and topped with just a little mango salsa. Northern just grilled straight up as it is as a steak with a little grilled artichoke.
Can I watch out for the bones with that one?
Nope.
No bones about it.
It is boneless.
So
this is
you are good to go. That is northern.
Oh, that's a big chunk of filet there.
Yeah.
So how about let's talk about maybe some tips with cooking
fish.
Sure.
Freshwater fish specifically.
So I think I brought
similar
along.
Like if you're cooking a fillet of salmon, or there's some unique characteristics.
It's a lot of the same tips and tricks apply. So you want to make sure you're going to have a good hot pan or grill.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to really help prevent some of that sticking.
Okay.
And you want to make sure you do oil it a bit. You don't need a lot of oil, but just.
Just any oil?
Just a touch, yep. This is a little of just plain old vegetable oil.
Wait for it, okay.
So I'm gonna get just a little bit in the pan and what I'm gonna do is take my little towel and kind of just spread it around just a little bit. And just get those grill grates good and greased.
What is this a pike fillet you have there?
This is a walleye fillet.
Walleye fillet.
So this is what everybody's going for.
That's our state fish.
Yeah.
Again, you're gonna want to get it smoking hot, and then your fish you want to season kind of appropriately before it goes on to the grill. Now, when doing a grilled walleye like this, I leave the skin on for it. Because it helps hold the fish together, and the fat on the bottom side of the skin helps keep the fish moist, so it helps prevent it from overcooking.
Will it peel like, I know when we cook salmon, I cook salmon all the time, it just comes right off.
It usually would just peel right off. Yeah. Yep. So you can just discard it when you're done.
You can eat it if you want.
You could.
Right?
Really?
Yep.
Isn't there nutrition in it?
I thought I heard it and let us know how it tastes.
You can.
I usually peel it.
When grilling like
my
this.
My dad says everything weird is nutritious, though. He always said that about potato peels, too.
Banana peels, your dad? He just bites right into it.
No, we fed those to the goat.
But with something like this, you know, it's not going to really cook long enough for the skin to get crispy the way you'd want it to, because we're doing kind of high heat, fast. So it's not going to be really what you want to eat, you know, the skin.
Yeah.
If you were doing it in a pan over a little lower heat, you could leave it on the skin side down a lot longer to help cook out that fat and crisp up the skin. But in this case, it's not really worth doing. So,
so you
the
just
other
did
thing,
salt.
I just did salt. That's all I'm doing
just
right
salt.
Now.
Salt.
So, and I'm going to take not this bad. And I'm going to just put it down. And that's what you want to hear right there.
You want skin side up.
Yep. And yeah, normally when I cook fish, if I'm going for crispy skin, I would go skin side down. But in this particular instance, I want the grill marks on the top, and we're not going to be using the skin anyway. So I'm going to start skin side down.
This is the dish that is walleye?
This is actually the perch. So this is perch, but they were done in several ways. The walleye's right here.
That's what we're doing now. Oh, these,
so
these are just other.
Oh, these are just other
snacks
examples.
We get to try. Mm,
I bet. They all look really good.
I know.
Wanted to bring a rainbow of fish.
And colorful. You don't think of
Minnesota lake fish
as being colorful dishes.
Unless we add the, you know, veggies and love.
And I think a lot of people get stuck into the shore lunch kind of concept where it's, we're going to bread it and pan fry it. And,
this is also good.
Which awesome.
There's so many fish fry. Every Friday, I feel like if you're up north, cabin country, it's fish fry
for
every
sure.
restaurant.
Well, but everybody knows how to do that.
Right.
So these are some unique
other
takes.
Ways.
Right. And people kind of got tired. And that's kind of why I came at this book this way is, well, let's see what we can do that's not just fried fish all the time, because there's so many great ways you can use it. You can get some real nice restaurant quality dishes. You can get some real easy brunch options.
I was gonna say,
definitely
catch your fish Saturday, then make one of these for mom on Sunday.
Yeah.
Absolutely, I bet she would love that.
Because this is a Spanish
Tortilla.
This looks like a good brunchy.
So this is
food.
It's a perfect brunch. It's basically a quiche without a crust.
Oh,
so it's really
fewer carbs.
There you go.
It's got potatoes.
Potatoes, okay.
Yeah,
yes. Darn. But it looks good.
Yeah.
So how long is this going, boy? So people.
So
know,
I'm gonna keep this
quick
for about minute and a half or so.
Okay.
And then what I'm gonna do at a certain point, and the thing is about fish is when it's done.
How do you know? Sometimes, like especially white fish, I don't know, because like pink fish, you can see it changes that color.
Right.
White, you're just like, is it flaky? How
well,
do you test it?
You know, in terms of sticking and getting it to remove from the pan, you know it's ready when it will release itself. Mm-hmm. Because what happens is it forms that crust. And once it forms that crust, it releases from the metal of the pot.
Oh.
So, you know, you can kind of see that.
It's
yeah.
like a kid in college.
Like
sure,
up here,
the
we're getting pretty close.
I'm ready to go.
How come you can't
I'm out.
Pin them?
So this came off pretty good. So what I'm going to do is just to get those grill marks that we kind of want, I'm
going
to just rotate it.
Flip flopping it.
Yep.
Giving a little diagonal grill mark.
You bet. We're going fancy.
Echo. Are you watching us over here?
Yeah, it's really good. Yeah, somebody commented on my shirt, lumberjack. Well, this is actually the picnic table.
He stole it from a family dining at a park nearby.
Yeah, you missed it in the first video, maybe.
We were trying to figure out where he got it from. Do you know H&M?
I thought you looked at the tag.
There isn't one.
Oh, then I don't know.
Well, wait, it's H&M.
Ah, see?
Extra small.
Very nice.
This is extra
children's
small?
Children's size. No, I'm kidding.
It's kind of big. Oh, anyway.
Wow.
Woo!
Yeah, you know, this is good, too, because fishing opened this weekend, but Memorial Weekend is already 2 weeks away. Can you believe
that? Yeah, and it's like when everyone's up getting their cabins ready.
4th of July. So you can impress your guests with the cabin, maybe, and make something a little bit fancier. And for those people who are not into fishing or are bad fishermen like me, we can actually get freshwater fish from coastal seafood?
You can get some stuff. We do, you know, some of these things we get sporadically.
So, maybe like call ahead and order.
Yeah, you can call ahead and check. Walleye is something we get in fairly often. Catfish, which is something I didn't bring today.
Catfish? See, I thought that was such an ugly fish. I never had it as
ugly.
A kid.
It's very delicious. They farm
really?
It now, and it's so the meat's really nice and clean. You know, it's again, it kind
of
had that old meat.
Yeah, right.
So those are, that's actually a really cost effective fish too. It's very cheap.
What is it? What would you compare it to? Like a cod?
It's probably a little bit closer to that than it would be like a, you know, a halibut
it's,
or something.
It's like softer.
It's kind of. It's almost denser, but it's still flaky.
Okay. Weird.
So it's
okay,
really
well, next
nice.
Next time you come, bring that because I would love to.
Yeah. For sure.
I never thought.
All right. Let's see how we're
tasty.
Looking here. All right. So we got pretty good golden brown going on.
And then you flipped it onto a skin.
And I flipped it on the skin side, and I'm just gonna let it kind of finish out here. And you'll check when it starts to kind of flake away, you know, you're pretty good. Usually most of the cooking is going to be done on one side,
yeah.
You know, about 2/3 of it. And then you just kind of give it another kiss on the other side for about a minute or
a
so.
Kiss, and, I like that, a kiss yeah. on the other side.
Kiss on the skin side. Give me some skin. You know, it's like how they high five.
Okay. You gotta do well, the fish.
I don't think I could do that.
I'm gonna figure out what camera we're on right now.
But all these particular fish, like, these are a good range of species because we do have alternatives for them. So, like, the lake trout, you could use a salmon, you could use a smoked yeah. salmon or
can
a smoked trout.
It?
Yeah, yes. please do.
I mean, it's just I've been waiting, looking I've been at the animal piece I want. This one has a lot.
Yeah, I like this. This looks good.
Yeah.
We're Minnesota nights. We're like, when should we ask? Oh,
dig in right away. So, yeah, you could, like I said, salmon, trout. you could use an Arctic char for that.
Mm.
Or any of the smoked varieties would be good. It's just a simple cream cheese base, fresh cucumbers, a little red onion.
I know, is this
peppers.
A pita?
Yeah,
what is it?
I'm just on a pita bread. You could use any kind of real flat bread that you like for it.
Talking with your mouth full. Sven and I went to an etiquette class, and we had a lot to learn. That story's going to air next week.
It should be entertaining.
Should be. And then you dropped it on the floor.
Mm. Whoops.
Mess. Such a mess. This is so good. Is there dill
crunch.
On it? Is there a dill? Or it tastes like, I don't know.
Yeah, I think there's a little bit of dill.
So any of these,
I was gonna put a little bit more on top.
So any of these four different variety of fish, you could cook a similar way, or
yeah.
are there different ways of cooking?
For sure. I mean, you could again, you could fry them, you can grill them, you could bake them, broil them, pan roast them, just like any fish. They're very versatile. The trick is that sometimes you know, like with perch are real small,
yeah.
So the time is you know,
less.
Yeah, it's a lot less.
You don't want to overdo it.
You got to make sure. Your heat's controlled right for that kind of thing because it can get a little out of control.
One thing with fish, when I'm cooking it, and same with my mom, my whole life growing up, my mom would say, I hate when fish tastes fishy, which is weird because it's fish. But you don't want it to taste, well, you don't want it to taste, like there's a certain fishy taste that sometimes puts you off. Is there a way
for sure.
You know what I mean? I don't know how to describe it. Is it like, it's like the stink smell of a fish that you taste, which you don't want to taste.
Right. So usually, like with ocean fish, that's the sign of a fish that's kind of degrading in quality when it's got that fishy smell.
I.e. rotting, you mean?
Basically.
Tell mom a little quit eating rotten fish.
Yeah, mom, wait a minute. Day old fish.
So when you're looking at fish like that, that you definitely don't want that smell. Lake fish, you know, because it's a wild caught game fish, it's going to have a little bit of a gamier flavor than some of those ocean fish. So it will have a little bit of that fishy, but you still don't want it. It shouldn't be strong. It shouldn't be overpowering.
Yeah.
It should be fairly mild. All these
fish. The nice thing about when you're cooking
so
Minnesota lake, you know, freshwater fish, you're usually cooking it pretty fresh.
Yeah.
Because you didn't have to wait for it or buy it or.
That's the idea. You know, I mean,
control.
You get people who
I'm
freeze
try
it.
One of these.
Yeah, no. Dig in.
Oh, I should try other things, but that first piece, I just couldn't get all the flavors right. I gotta try it again.
That's become
just
kind
kidding.
Of a new family favorite.
This is so good.
This is good too.
This is good because it's got like that fresh veggies and it just tastes so, it tastes healthy.
And so this
when
is,
it tastes, and it, but it's good.
This is a little more complicated than that, right?
Actually, this is pretty simple, yeah. Basically, all
I mean,
you do
complicated
is.
For me.
How about he just picks it up with his hands?
Yeah, that's perfect.
That's great.
Oh, no, it's finger food.
It's the way to go. But yeah, no, for that, it's thinly sliced potatoes with the trout and the roasted red peppers, and then I just dumped the eggs over the top, put it in the oven, and...
Oh, so it's like a little egg bag.
Yeah, basically.
Ah.
Just did it in a skillet, and then turned it out and cut it. Very, very simple.
So
this one has walleye?
That's trout.
Trout.
Lake trout. These are both lake trout.
Every time I point out the fish, I get it wrong.
There's a lot of mix up with species.
Good morning, everybody. Danny calls you a lumberjack. Mm-hmm. Good morning, Danny. People are waving. Who's ready for fish? That's a question. What I guess we could ask you, what's like your favorite fish? I feel like walleye is the most popular. Typically, like walleye fingers, hands down my favorite thing. You dip it in like a little
walleye
sauce.
Yeah, again, walleye is by far gonna be the most popular fish.
And like I said, we're not very good at fishing in my family, so we ate a lot of sunfish.
Yeah.
But they're very flavorful.
I really like sunfish.
And what I like about sunfish is you're burning more calories eating them than you are getting from them because there's so little meat.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to pick out bones and
stuff.
Yeah,
I'm not a big,
there's so many great things you can do with sunfish. You know, again, in the book, we cover a lot of different, I think it's 11 different species of lake fish.
I don't think I could list 11 off the top of my head.
So are these recipes in the book?
Yes, these are all recipes that are in the book.
I just happened to flip to sunfish risotto.
Perfect.
Doesn't that sound good?
It's a great springtime dish, fishing opener.
Look at that.
Mm. Fresh asparagus.
Why didn't you make that one?
That's a good question.
It's coming. It's in the oven.
Well, what I can imagine with sunfish, instead of like, you know, what you're saying is my grandma would just bread them, fry them up like pretty much whole.
Sure.
Minus the head. And then you just kind of pick them apart. But you could pick off the meat after you cook them and put them in something like this.
Oh, yeah,
right?
Yeah.
That's what you're
absolutely
doing, I'm guessing.
And for those, you know, I just
you
use
need
fillets.
Only, and... You need 30 sunfish, and then you have...
Yeah, cool. Again, it depends on the size, but sometimes you need quite a few. Yeah.
So. A lot of
my family,
smelt.
They catch so many, say, sunnies, and they flay them up right away, but they freeze them. Do you recommend that you just, like, thaw them out completely? Can you cook them frozen?
Generally, I think it's best to thaw them completely before you do it.
Yeah, it was like stupid question.
No.
My Gordon fish sticks. Because
you can.
Swipe.
You certainly can, but I think you're going to get a little bit of better water, even cook if you...
Now, smelt, I think, is pretty unique in that you only get it around Lake Superior, right?
We can get it here. We actually carry smelt up at the shop.
It's big in, in Duluth.
Yeah.
There's smelt runs.
Right, yeah, and that's where they come from.
They go to where the streams go into Lake Superior, and they catch smelt.
Yep.
I'd never heard of it before because I grew up down here. But
it's a big thing up there.
Yeah, the, smelt runs.
The smelt fries with the beer.
Do you have a recipe with eel pout in here?
I don't have any
eel pout recipes. I wanted to get into
I feel like that's an underserved fish that gets a bad rap.
It's actually a freshwater relative of cod.
Is it?
Yeah.
So it's not as nasty as it looks?
No.
I'm just digging in.
It's kind of a big deal. Please, again, go for it.
Which one is this one again?
That's the northern.
Oh, and I've never had northern.
Since you had two of these.
And this is the one that a lot of people don't ever try.
Oh, okay.
No,
it's, like, wait.
No, it's just, again, because they don't want to clean it. And
that was that's
quite... What is that, like, lemony?
Just a lemon and garlic aioli. Very simple.
Simple yet delicious.
Yep.
That's so good. You have to try that.
So that's actually a variation on a recipe in the book. I wanted to make this because I wanted to show people kind of how flexible some of these things are. So in the book, the northern is pan roasted and the artichokes are actually deep fried. Oh. Same sauce, same garnish, everything. But it's so nice out and it's kind of a good springy weekend. It was grill it. Same dish, just grilled instead of fried. So it's a little lighter,
like
a little bit more seasonal.
I'm just coming in for seconds.
The picnic table on. So.
True, you have to get the most on your shirt.
I want to get a little bit of that.
That's really tasty. That aioli sauce. So it's just literally just like, how do you make that?
It's mayo, a little lemon. Mayo, lemon juice, garlic, salt, pepper. Real simple.
I gotta get a little bit of this thing.
Yeah.
Have to get all the flavors.
Those grilled artichokes are really nice, and you could use. I actually use the canned ones for these because I kind of like the brininess that's with them.
I'm gonna get a little, okay.
But you gotta rinse them real good first. But you could also use frozen or fresh if you wanted to go and do that.
I got it.
There you go.
10 minutes later.
That's the way.
What are the green? Are those leeks?
Tarragon.
Oh, tarragon. That's my second choice. I was gonna say.
Helps brighten it up a little bit.
That's really good. Wow. Sweet.
We have people watching then, from.
What should we try?
Yeah.
Just like us.
We haven't had the perch tacos yet.
Dig into that. And it's a very just classic fish taco.
Ready? Do you want some lemon on yours?
Sure. I feel like are the freshwater, so they're almost all white fish.
I'm taking it over here.
It's all about, with the exception of the trout.
You have to season them a little, or do things so to kind of bring out the natural flavor, like this, the lemony, what is this word you're saying?
The aioli.
I was eating something else while you guys were on that.
Is this for this one, the perch? Oh, there goes something.
Did you put lemon on all these?
On all of them. Is it a mango salsa, you said?
It is just it's a mango salsa, so real simple. You could, if you wanted to, season up the fish with a little, you know, cumin or paprika.
Look how he eats his taco.
That seems like a champion way to do it.
No, this is the weirdest. What do you like? You think someone's going to steal it out of your hand and run away? What are you?
Hey, I was a fat kid for a reason.
It's the weirdest way. Like
I grew up in a litter. If you didn't run with your food.
That's
great. If you didn't eat fast enough, you didn't eat in the Sundgaard household. Uh-huh. This is really good.
Yeah, again.
Corn tortilla. You just like heat them up on the grill, too?
Yeah, heat them up on the grill. And
I think this is the first time I've ever eaten perch.
Really? It's a lot like walleye. They're very similar fish.
Aren't they related, actually?
They are related. But perch tend to have a little bit of a sweeter flavor. In fact, a lot of people actually prefer perch to walleye, right?
The littler we are, the sweeter we are. Right, Alicia?
That's what they say. Here, I'll bring this over here, too.
Oh, that's good. I'm talking my mouthful now, too. Mm-hmm. Look at you passing your bad manners.
It's crazy.
Oh, we have
nice.
We're not at the St. Paul Hotel anymore.
Come scavenge.
Scavenge away. Mm-hmm.
Due to our photojournalist and Marissa DeCanita, mm-hmm. they always come and they try to eat after, but we're just kind of eating now.
Get in here now.
I want to see the progress. I just missed it.
We don't pay Judah very much, so this is how
he eats. I'm trying this. Oh, I should take off the skin, shouldn't I? Good.
I mean, I could smell it just down the road.
Like, yeah, it should just come right off.
This looks good. I'm going to just take it out of the way, though.
Oh, all right. So that's
so which one's this one? Mm.
This is a lake trout flatbread.
Seems like you're in front of my camera.
Lake trout flatbread.
Yep. So it's real simple. Wow. Cream cheese.
Oh, she likes it.
Cucumbers,
good?
Red onion.
How's it, Duda? First bite? First impression? Mm. Wow. He gave it the nod. Mm. That means it's good.
So good.
Ooh, awesome. The nice. Aftertaste is even better.
So all these recipes, again, in the book.
In the book.
Coastal Seafoods, you guys are again located where?
We've got two shops, Minneapolis over on Minnehaha, and then in St. Paul on Stelling and Grand.
Cool, and they can get these local fish sometime, whenever they're in season. I guess it's all seasonal stuff.
Absolutely, I mean, cool. Call ahead and check, and again, walleye is something we have fairly regularly. Lake trout is something we get pretty regularly. The catfish, again, which I did not bring, we have pretty often.
Probably not gonna find as much of these fish when the lakes are froze over, because you just don't catch as much ice fishing.
Right.
That's true. Well, thank you so much again for the time. Sorry, I cut Sven off.
Always happy to come back.
You're done talking. Alicia. He's got to return his tablecloth to the family he stole it from.
Before they wake up.
Well, thanks again for stopping by. This is so good. We're going to pig out their mouths are watering, and they're going to wait to come in here. Next week, we're making pannekuchen. You know what that is?
I know what a pannekuchen is.
Pannekuchen. Yeah. So stop by next week, Thursday, 9 o'clock.
You know what it is? You never heard of it?
Never heard of it? Tune in. Oh. I never heard of it either. I heard it's good.
What?
I don't know.
It's a Dutch pancake.
I'm Dutch, too. I should know this. All right. Bye, everybody.